Hey guys, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So guys, this is the video where we are going to discuss a lot of questions that can be of relevance for your RBI, SEBI and NABARD examinations. So we will quickly begin with the questions, but let me introduce the students who are coming for the first time with the Telegram channel of ours. Guys, this PDF is available on that channel and you can join our Telegram channel through the link given in description below. One more thing that I want to state here is that I'm really glad at the responses that I have got from you all regarding the GK Factory initiative that I have begun. So in continuation of that initiative only, last time on Friday, I talked about the world's driest place. The soil of that place is often compared to that of Mars. So that was the Atacama Desert, which is largely in Chile. Today, I'm going to talk about the desert, which is densely populated. So yes, desert is one place where life is deemed as next to impossible, but still there is one desert in the world which is as high as 83 people are found there in per square kilometer area. So this is the population density of that desert. So which desert am I going to talk about? Guess karte raho jab tak hum wahan tak nahi pahunchte. But if you want to know about that desert as well as some interesting facts related to that, then you have to stick to this video till the end of this video. And in the meantime, believe me, you are not going to waste your time, because the questions that we are going to discuss, they will be definitely of use for you if you are preparing for any examination. Okay. So the very first question that we have is, which of the following country has not been invited as the chief guest for Republic Day 2022? Kyrgyzstan, Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, Azerbaijan, Tajikistan. The right answer here is Azerbaijan has not been invited. Okay, so let me show you first in the map. So this is India, New Delhi, as you can see, this is our Jammu and Kashmir, and Ladakh, of course. So this is the Central Asian region from where the countries have been invited. The leaders of these countries have been invited as the chief guest for the Republic Day 2022. Now here two things are of importance. First one is that the majority of these countries are bordering Afghanistan. So this makes it all the more important, because Afghanistan's situation is precarious, particularly if we look at India's relation with Afghanistan, both in terms of terrorism as well as in terms of diplomatic relations, okay, that we already had in Afghanistan. Because of those relationships, we developed many developmental projects in Afghanistan, okay. Next factor of importance related to this is that this is the second time that so many countries are invited as chief guest for the Republic Day. First one was in 2018 when Asian leaders were invited, okay? And this is of course the first time when the Central Asian leaders, all the Central Asian leaders are invited as Republic Day chief guest. So now let's have a look at the chiefs of these countries. I hope that it is visible to you all. Huh. So the president of Kazakhstan is this person. Kasam Jormat Tokayev. Kyrgyzstan's president is Sadir Japarov. Uzbekistan's president is Shavkat Mirziyoyev. Okay, I know that these names are very difficult, even this much difficult that they are not even able to pronounce properly. Okay, but we have to memorize these names. Now, whose name do you need to memorize? First of all, do not forget the name of this person. Okay, because he is going to chair 2022 SCO summit. So this is important. So this is one thing. Then we have Tajikistan's president Imamoli Rahman, who chaired 2021 SCO summit. Okay, so this is also important. And this is Turkmenistan. Can you guys tell me which project are we developing between Turkmenistan, Pakistan, Afghanistan and India? Okay, so I hope that you have already guessed that which initiative am I talking about. You just have to elaborately mention it in the comment section below, that which project is this. Okay, this project is related to which sector. these were the leaders of the Central Asian countries that are invited by India for Republic Day. And as I have already told you that you should not take any chance in memorizing the leaders of these two countries, okay, because of SCO. So that was all about the chief guest for Republic Day. Now let's move on to the next question. Which of the following states has established the Samanya Varg Ayog for general category? So we have Himachal Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, only A and B, and B and C in the options. Right answer is option D, A and B, Himachal Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. Now write the at the present moment, Himachal Pradesh has established this Samanya Varg Ayog, that is the general category commission. Okay, and the basic purpose is to hear the grievances of the general category people and find a solution to their problem. Now, akin to this, Madhya Pradesh, basically Madhya Pradesh has already established this kind of a commission, and following the footsteps of Madhya Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh has also established this, although there were huge protests in Himachal Pradesh because of which the government was pressurized to establish this thing, but still, as far as our examination is concerned, we need to focus on the clear facts that are there. So first, Madhya Pradesh was the state that established the Samanya Varg Ayog, then Himachal Pradesh has established it, and it became the second state to have this Ayog. Moving on to the third question, what is the global average score of the Global Health Security Index 2021? So global average score, so we have 38.9 as the global average score in terms of health. Now you would be shocked to know that no country, now here we have two to three facts that are very shocking in terms of health. First is that no country is ready to prevent any future epidemic or pandemic situation like corona. Secondly, even the high income countries, like we have high income countries like US, Canada, so these are in the high income category. These countries are not even allocating sufficient funds to strengthening their response to the epidemics and pandemics. So these are the two statements that I found very shocking from this report. Now, apart from the statements, apart from the opinions, this report has also given us a ranking because it's a index. So let's have a look at the rankings, parameters, etc. First of all, this is the second edition of this index. It is released by Nuclear Threat Initiative and John Hopkins Center for Health Security. Can you guys tell me where are these two organizations located? Okay. So total 195 countries are assessed. US, Australia, Finland. These are the top three countries. India is at the 66th rank, so which is not a very bad ranking because we have 195 countries in total. So out of those 195 countries, India ranks at 66th position. However, improvements are still needed. Score of India is 42.8. At the bottom, we have Somalia. 37 indicators are there, which are divided into six categories. Okay, so these are the six categories of this index. First one is prevention of the emergence of release of pathogens. Okay, so this one is the first parameter, that is prevent. How can you memorize it? That prevent from spreading of pathogens. So this one is the first parameter of this index. Second one is early detection and reporting epidemics of potential international concern. So this is detection and reporting of pathogens. If you relate it to corona situation, then you will be able to memorize it really easily. First is prevention, how corona spread across the country even after the news of corona epidemic has spread all over the world. Still, the world was not able to prevent it from happening in their own countries. For example, in India also, we knew that there is an epidemic that is spreading in China, and we border China. Therefore, we should be more cautious regarding this pandemic, but still we did not close our land borders. We did not close the traveling air travel at the right moment. And because of that, the pandemic spread in India also. Not only this thing, there were other reasons as well. Not only the borders with China were a concern of spreading of corona, there were other travelers also from around the world who were in contact with the Chinese people, and then they brought the corona in India. So that was a very tricky situation, but still, we need to have something, we should have done something in order to prevent corona when we already knew that such an epidemic was spreading in a country that is the land border country of ours. Next, the third parameter is rapid response to and mitigation of the spread of the epidemic. Okay, so the third one is response. Sufficient and robust health sector to treat the sick and protect health workers. So frontline workers, exactly frontline workers word is not here, so don't put this word here, but still for the ease of your memorizing, I have put this word here because frontline is the word that we have used many a times in the pandemic duration. So sufficient healthcare system and the protection system for the frontline workers or the healthcare workers, particularly commitment to improving national capacity, financing and adherence to norms. So norms, how much commitment the countries have made towards financing and adherence to norms that would prevent such a pandemic or epidemic from happening in the future. Next is overall risk, environment and country vulnerability to biological threats. So guys, these are the six parameters of this index. I hope that now you will be easily able to memorize these parameters. Now let's have a look at the opinions that this report has mentioned. Actually, I should not say opinions, these are the facts in actuality. So the very first fact is the global average score, which is 38.9, which has declined from 40.2, which was in 2019. No country is fully prepared. No country scored even above 75.9. So this is the very precarious situation in terms of health. The world is acutely vulnerable to health emergencies in the future. Most countries, including high income countries, have not made dedicated financial investments in strengthening their preparedness. Time period which was assessed in this report is this: August 2022 to June 2021. Now guys, there were facts as well, like the percentage of countries who have not given sufficient funds to health preparedness and etc. But I did not pick up those facts for two reasons. First reason is that those facts are not particularly asked in your examinations. Okay. Second reason is that so much of facts would hamper your understanding of this report. Now, these points are very important points which you can yourself quote in your ESI answers if there is an answer on COVID or if there is an answer on the healthcare system. Okay. So then you can cite this report and the observations that this report has made in terms of health. Okay. So that was all about this report. Now let's move on to the next question. With which institute has Ministry of Defense signed an MOU to facilitate training to teachers of Sainik schools? So guys, here the right answer is option E, Indian Institute of Teacher Training in Gandhinagar. Okay, so here two things are important. First one is that this institution has partnered with the Ministry of Defense. Second is the target. So right now we have 33 Sainik schools presently working in India, and the target is to have 100 more Sainik schools. Now, how will the 100 Sainik schools be established? Don't think that we are going to construct these 100 more Sainik schools in India. Okay, this is basically the initiative of affiliating the existing government, private and other schools with the Sainik school society. Okay, so by affiliation, the number of Sainik schools will be increased by 100 by the government of India. So do remember that this is the target. Targets are always important. So the next question is, in which country is New Caledonia located? Sorry, in which ocean is New Caledonia located? So the right answer here is Pacific Ocean. Now, where does this question come from? So let's first have a look at the news. So this न्यू कैलेडोनिया? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इट इज एन आर्किपेलेगो. आर्किपेलेगो इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ आइलैंड्स दैट फॉर्म अ नेशन. ओके, अ कंट्री. सो न्यू कैलेडोनिया आर्किपेलेगो इज अ फ्रेंच टेरिटरी एंड रिसेंटली अ रेफरेंडम हैज बीन पास्ड बाय द पीपल ऑफ दिस टेरिटरी दैट दे वॉन्ट टू स्टे अंडर द सोवरेनिटी ऑफ फ्रांस. ओके, सो दैट्स द न्यूज फॉर विच दिस इज हियर. French president is Emmanuel Macron. So this was another important fact because he expressed his gratitude over this referendum. That's why he was also in the news. Now let's have a look at the location. This is Ilia and this is the New Caledonia archipelago. Okay, if you zoom it out, then you can see this is New Caledonia and these are the small islands that make up it as an archipelago, and all of these make up the New Caledonia territory or the nation, as we can see. Next question is, which organization has released the BRICS Economic Bulletin 2021 report? So here the right answer is Reserve Bank of India. Okay, so here the one thing that is important is the theme of this report: navigating the ongoing pandemic, the BRICS experience of resilience and recovery. Developers of this report: BRICS Contingency Reserve Arrangement Research Group, with the members from central banks of BRICS nations. But the predominant member of this report, or the organization that has released this report, is RBI. India's recovery will be higher than other BRICS nations. So this was one point that I found very prominent. Therefore, I have put it here. Otherwise, this report has very descriptive kind of points that are not relevant for the examination, particularly for your phase one exam. Therefore, I have skipped all of them. They are not really very important, guys. So don't go into the details of these kinds of reports. Which payment bank has partnered with NPCI Bharat Bill Pay to facilitate cash-based assisted bill payments at the doorstep of customers? So here the right answer is India Post Payment Bank. So what this NPCI Bharat Bill Pay has done, it has partnered with this bank so that the recurring nature payment can be done. Basically, for those payments, cash will be collected from the people from their doorsteps. Okay, that's the whole idea behind this partnership. Now there is one more news related to the India Post Payment Bank, that is that it has been included in the second schedule of RBI Act 1934. That gives it the status of a scheduled bank. Okay, so there are three payment banks in the scheduled bank list. First one is Fino, then India Post Payment Bank, Paytm Payments Bank. Okay, so the news was related to Paytm payment, guys. India Post Payment Bank was already there in the second schedule of RBI Act 1934, so it has not been included right now. It's the Paytm Payments Bank that has been included in the second schedule of RBI Act 1934. Now these are the six payment banks that are operational in India right now. Airtel, India Post. Now Airtel Payment Bank is the very first payment bank that operated in India, that started in India, and Jio Payment Bank is the very latest one. Okay, Fino Payment Bank, Paytm, NSDL and Jio Payment Bank. Now it's time for our GK Factory initiative. So let's have a look at the desert. So which desert is it? From the very look of it, you can yourself judge. It's the Great Indian Desert, that is the Thar Desert of India. So this is one region, this is one desert that has a very highly dense, this is one region which has the most amount of population, we can say. Most number of people reside in this desert. Now, I don't know how many of you already had known this fact, that this desert is not only restricted to Rajasthan, it is spread across four states in India, and also it is there in Pakistan, and it has another name is in Pakistan. So first let me tell you that in India itself it is spread in Rajasthan, Gujarat, Haryana, and we have Punjab. So these are the four states in which the Thar desert is spread. In Pakistan, it is spread in the Sindh and Punjab province. And in the Punjab province of Pakistan, it is known as the Cholistan. Another name of Thar. So Pakistanis have renamed the Thar desert in the Punjab province as the Cholistan. So I hope that you are glad to know this fact if you did not know this earlier. Okay, so this is only written here. Now this is the beautiful Thar desert, and because of its long history, because of its highly dense high population, this is the beauty that the humans have created in the Thar desert, in the very secluded place of Thar desert, of a desert. So these are the forts. No need to remember the names of the forts, because here we are going to know some interesting facts related to Thar. So I have already told you that it is most densely populated desert where the lives are next to impossible, but people are residing here. You would also be shocked to know that 70% of Rajasthan's total area is covered by the Thar desert. So this is how it is great. This is the population, more than 80 people per kilometer square. So this is how densely populated this area is. Average precipitation is 100 to 500 millimeters. Now guys, Thar desert is a subtropical desert, okay? I know that these are tropical deserts, and there is a classification of deserts. I'm not going to go into that, because here we have to restrict ourselves to the interesting facts related to Thar. So among the subtropical deserts, Thar is one of the deserts that receive a good amount of rainfall, which is empirically proved by this rainfall precipitation that is there in the Thar desert, 100 to 150 millimeters. The next fact related to this is that this desert has a very good presence of biodiversity. Okay, so black buck is already there in Rajasthan, and we all know what black buck is famous for. World's 17th largest desert. So this is the world's 17th largest desert. 85% of it lies in India, 15% is in Pakistan. Aravali range of mountains surround this desert. 70% of this of Rajasthan's total area is Thar. Now first let's have a look at these three wildlife sanctuaries. So in the very secluded space of desert, now Thar desert is not secluded, we can say, but still in the desert we have national parks. So one national park is Desert National Park. So here, what kind of species do we find? Basically, this national park is famous for chinkara, desert cat, fox, and great Indian bustard. So great Indian bustard is this, okay? Tal Chapar Wildlife Sanctuary, which is famous for black bucks. Then we have Sundha Mata Wildlife Sanctuary. Basically, this wildlife sanctuary has many animals, therefore it is not famous for just one or two, okay? So these are the wildlife sanctuaries which are located in Thar desert, in the desert area of Thar. And these are the animals, these are the migratory birds that migrate from Mongolia and China to Rajasthan's Thar desert. So there are birds, there is natural vegetation, there is animals who are migrating to a desert which is in India. So let's have a talk about the rich tradition of Thar desert as well, because we all know that Rajasthan is one area which is very rich in folk art and culture. So we have a very prominent presence of art and culture. Agriculture and animal husbandry, both of these are the main occupations of the people here. 40% of Rajasthan's total population live in the Thar desert, and the largest river of this desert is Luni River, because life is not possible without water. There are a lot of salt water lakes as well, but those were the salt water lakes, therefore those were not very important, and those were lakes. This is the river which is very important. Luni River is the most important river, and the most important fact or interesting fact related to this river is that it does not fall into a sea. it does not fall into the Arabian Sea. It goes to Gujarat, and in the run of Gujarat, it just mix with that marshy land of run of Kutch. It does not go into the Arabian Sea. So again, we had a very interesting fact that there is a river which is not meeting the sea, and that too was in India. So that was all about this, guys. So I hope that you have liked this video. How much did you like the facts related to Thar Descent? Do mention it in the comment section also. Also mention the answers of the questions that I have asked you. Thank you so much for watching this video.